First comes the Vanguard, unstoppable tank. Then comes a second, attacking the flank. Finally, the General, the highest in rank. A trio of blades, swift as a gale. They cut to the bone and kill without fail. Running into the darkness, fangs snapping at your heels. When at last you stop to rest, a quick look around reveals. You walked straight into a nest, littered with previous meals. Don't stop. Don't linger. Don't sleep in this den. For the beast will find you, and you'll never wake again. A moment of peace, soon to be disturbed. A threat approaches, its hunger uncurbed. It rakes up its lunch, chows down without grace. But inside this nest, for thieves there's no place. It needs to escape, or get egg on its face. Cursed hunting ground. Those who set foot there never again are found. For when the bird wyvern comes and unleashes its breath, its virulent poison brings a swift death. Roaming hill and dale. A gluttonous brute leaves a sluggish trail. Attempts to sate its hunger prove of no avail. It keeps eating more and more. And with every bite, it succumbs yet further to its destructive appetite. On a frosty mountain range, far from human haunts, an abominable beast does whatever it wants. Is it hare or is it bear? It is neither, so beware. It will drench the snow with blood and wreak nothing but despair. Austere mountains, devoid of reason and laws. rounded mass descends, made of fangs and claws. Tumbling, tumbling, closer and closer. And when it unfurls, your time will be over. A bamboo forest at night. The sound of dancing is heard. Resembling a parasol, but in truth a monstrous bird. Be wary of its figure and its vibrant hue. For once its collar opens, a rain of blood will ensue. A shallow forest stream coursing through the night. Amid the sound of water, a beast prepares to fight. Those who go in unprepared will bow before its might. Bathing in the thorns, it waits, using water as its shield. Yellow collar standing proud, its fang shall never yield. Desolate wasteland, perfect for light-hearted hunts. But do not let your guard down. Don't pull any stunts. For the mud hides secrets, and none of them are good. Where once was sand and water, a monster is now sand. Eternal creatures coming out to feast find themselves becoming prey to this long-necked beast. Down the hatch they go, definitely deceased. Craven miscreant, show your mug if you dare. But when it turns to face you, you'd rather be elsewhere. Its perturbing expression, a sight too much to bear. Floating in water, it beckons silently. Once its prey approaches, there is no time to flee. Gut and strength alike rank among the greats. Don't get pushed out of the ring. The abyss awaits. On the road to perdition. Stands a false sentry with a devilish mission. Once it spots movement, it puts its tail in position. Its plan to pelt prey coming into fruition. For this is its territory. and there is no admission. An evening looking for a snack to swallow whole. Never mind the taste. Satiety is the goal. Not enough, not enough. The beast growls for more. Anything is game for a true omnivore. Cursed marsh. Said to be haunted. Hostile and harsh. A place of deep peril. True quagmire. For those who get stuck. The darkness of the night, fragrant blossom bloom. As bandits prowl out of sight, a sudden resounding boom. This is not the mountain's roar. Do not be mistaken. What seemed like rocks are rocks no more. And as soon as they awaken, the monster shows its actual form. Both prey and earth are shaken. A miraculous spring, clear as children's song. Deep runs its stream, elegant but strong. A lullaby is sung, soft sounds of seduction. Its dulcet tones inducing sleep and serpentine destruction. Arid plains at night, flames billowing high. This is where she makes her realm. Best to not go nigh. Fire scorching the earth. Lighting up the sky. When her highness sets her eyes on you, it's time to say goodbye. Biting cold, freezing winds cutting deep. Enter its domain, and the price will be steep. Don't fall for the charm of its shining white gown, for it will tear you up. Before taking you down. flying shadow, stalking through the night. The wind, with eyes shining bright. Always craving blood, lightning running through its fur. When it swoops down on its prey, all becomes a blur. A grudge towards all life, given form in flame. Stalks unsuspecting creatures. That it seeks to maim. Its prey turns round to face it, preferring a hero's death. Knowing that this purple fire will steal its final breath. Pray for its soul. For this creature of pure evil shall swallow the world whole. Tremors in the night. A feline runs in fright, hiding out of sight. But soon it is found, shivering in fear. And when it looks around, its foes already here. Run, young feline, run! You have to get away! For this beast is never done until it snags its prey. Now here is a creature with smugness and guts. Haughty and arrogant. Look as it struts. Enter its turf and suffer your fate. Watch as its eyes fill with rancor and hate. Don't try to run. It's already too late. Light blue bubbles, reflecting the moonlight. Fragile and ephemeral, like flowers blooming at night. Traces of a creature, graceful in its precision. Noble, yet beguiling. An entrancing vision. Run, run! The beast is on its way. From the snowy depths, it comes to find its prey. With its chilling breath, it forms a blade of ice. Then it goes out hunting for something to excise. One wrong one step, and it's too late. The beast hears all, returns irate. A cave of crimson, flames billowing high. That is where he makes his nest. Best to not go nigh. Fire scorching the earth rains down from the sky. When His Highness sets his eyes on you, it's time to say goodbye. Laying in the dirt after a hard day's work. A grumpy old beast rises from the murk. Resounds. None shall ever enter this creature's holy grounds. Look upon its prowess, its movement full of spark. Its claws cut through the silence, its fangs bite through the dark. Gaze upon perfection, thunder given form. Either knock its lights out, or die fighting the storm. A deafening roar, rolling over hill and dale. The weak flee in fear, but the strong prevail. On the snowy mountainside, white is drenched with red. When the ancient tyrant hunts, all are filled with dread. Suddenly, a rumbling, a world-shattering sound. Twin horns split the sand below, no longer earthbound. For this is the true ruler of this dry dystopia. Trespasser shall be punished. Protect thy cornucopia. Crawling with a mincing gait. Dressed in a white gown. Aimlessly she roams, queen without a crown. Her beloved children, always by her side, share their mother's temper and her fiery pride. At a distant flight lies an island of fire. There walks a dark beast, a great ball of ire. Wielders of flame, who dare to engage? Will only succeed at igniting its rage. For it's the top player, and the world is at stake.
Where is my queen? Where is my queen? I am Storm incarnate. I shall wipe the land clean. So we may meet at last in paradise unseen. My king, oh my king, come forth now with haste. With my elegant lightning, let us lay this land to waste. Tear apart the skies, rend the clouds asunder. With hurricane and thunder.
Dashing across a snowy plain, monsters nipping at the heel. Out of breath, limbs in pain, doomed to end as meal. One last stand, a final try, to die a hero's death. Then help arrives from the sky, like a divine breath. Desolated ruins. A thief stalks through the mist. Driven by a lust for wealth, it just cannot resist. Begone, O foul miscreant. For these are sacred grounds. The dead dwell here. This is their realm. And you've overstepped its bounds. But other things live here as well, equally concealed. So be mindful of your insolence, lest your fate be sealed. In the the halls of Inferno roam the restless souls. The lone monarch approaches with the fire he controls. He's here to judge the wicked who sully his domain. To damn them with his rage to eternal pain. Swift as wind his punishment, absolute his reign. Nature is a battlefield, steeped in crimson dust. And the smoke of combat summons those who lust for blood and fiery violence and something to combust. Raining down destruction, pandemonium galore. Friend or foe, irrelevant. It hungers for hot war.
Divine beasts with grace replete, finally the twain shall meet. My queen, smite the earth with your thunder. My king, let storm tear the clouds asunder. With lightning and hurricane, we sear and slice. For we are the architects of true paradise. Let us form our final bond to rule the world and all beyond.
Up at the sky in fear. The crimson comet draws near. The light of the stars burns the earth to ash. Rends heaven in twain. With a final flash. Fearful fidgety felines, advancing through the night. When suddenly out of nowhere, a horrid face causes fright. Be calm. There's no need to cry or moan. It's just some old weather-beaten bone. Yet not all is what it seems. For below this giant skull, it's a devious monster waiting for some prey to go.
Opportunity may present itself from the most unexpected of places. As folly begets yet more folly. And even if it results in a disaster of unknown proportions, the cycle of stupidity created by these creatures could appear like a feast to the crazed eye. A pure creature, lingering to its heart's content. It looks docile and innocent at first glance. But if it's disturbed from its peaceful desires, pure anger becomes pure strength. As its power grows, so does its ire. Getting in its way is risking life and limb. It's already too late to realize that this creature's desires are not to be trifled with. With a fearsome leap, the hunter thinks its prey vanquished. But what it finds are not the spoils of victory, but discarded armor shed like a husk. And when the beast finds its next target, it doesn't think twice about leaving its old shell behind. It finds new armor to don, its blades as deadly as ever. Those who oppose it have no choice but to atone with their lives. A song drifts softly over snowy soil, bewitching and seducing all those unfortunate enough to be in earshot. And before they even sense it, they find themselves frozen to the bone. Helpless as their life is drained away. How the song ends, they will never know. For this minstrel shall never refrain. Hail moonlight, barely breaking through the clouds. A creature wanders restlessly through the darkness. Stepping firmly, never dropping its pace. Its entire body honed to perfection. Finally, the clouds split apart and the moon reveals itself. Silver light illuminates the land and the mountains. It dances. It runs. It trembles with unbridled power. And with an entranced roar, it shows its true form. all it takes to extinguish fragile life. When struck by its lightning, the effect will endure until death. An example of its violent, murderous nature. No matter how many lives are sacrificed, it will never subside. As if the copious amounts of blood it sheds can never be enough. Corpses strewn about below foreshadow an unexpected arrival. Before long, golden blades fall from the sky, tearing everything to shreds. With the blinding sun behind its back, the savage sniper appears. Those who try to evade their inevitable deaths by going in for the attack will only succeed at fulfilling the creature's cravings. As it soars high into the sky and marks another golden blade. Who goes there? A burning question that shakes the air and rings in the ears. Who goes there? A second time, tension rising like the heat and the rocks. But there is no time to answer. For the lord of this domain has risen from the fiery depths, smiling fearlessly. Gliding down its face. Unfazed by an onslaught of flames, it spreads its own blazing fire in return. As if to deride the pitiful sparks of its insolent prey. This is where it dwells quietly, blending into its environment. And if any should appear to disturb its peaceful slumber, they will soon find out that this mistake will cost them their lives. No one could have seen it coming. This stalking shadow. The mist that envelops it. An evil force that consumes its prey. It's already too late. Even those who struggle in a desperate effort to survive are beaten and pinned down by its overwhelming force. Not until the end, when all is over, will it reveal its ghastly form. What seems an easy target is a serpent on a leash. Reeled in at its mistress's command. They close in, cling on, subdue, restrain. Until they engulf their prey in flames. Baked and strong like a glazed ham. Those who let themselves be lured into the trap whisked away by a swift gale, the embodiment of darkness. A darkness that does not let its victims go, as they are slowly drained of their life. The servants keep providing their master with vital essence. And once the time is ripe, the darkness will show itself, basking in moonlight. Beasts find themselves in a place they don't belong. And when the master of this land appears, not even the mightiest attacks can do it any harm. With its overwhelming strength, it pummels and pins down its prey. Its endless anger fills the air in the form of a deafening roar as it prepares to feast without leaving a single bone. Its voice can be heard. The time has come. From the depth it beckons, come to me. As it feeds on stolen life, its power grows ever stronger. Until it applause. As fervor wells up and turns into rage. Hear me, O flames of those devoured. Restless spirits doomed to serve a creature of malice. Your will is connected no matter how faint. And though you are destined to fade before long, I implore you, before making your way to purgatory, you must bear witness. To the power of your own souls, manifested as relentless evil. At the the end of this sea of billowing fire. Its irate master will finally show its form. With feet firmly on the ground, nothing can stop my advance. Go ahead, form my plans. Attack if you so dare. I am the queen. And thou shalt bow before me. Sluggish brute, fierce but foolish, challenging the king, its graceful wings drawing a silver arch in the sky. In a flash, the tables turn. Stay aground and curse your fate, whilst your body is consumed by flame. Beneath the brightly shining moon, it does not merely bask in the light, but absorbs the moon's brilliance and uses it as a veil. And with unmatched speed, death comes swiftly, an elegant and gracious form, never witnessed by its prey. Its hunger satisfied, the beast rests, oblivious to the approaching threat. Too late now to escape, its fate to become pitiful prey. Or is it? For what appears to be prey, struggling in vain to flee, soon becomes a beguiling dance, and the hunter finds itself the hunted. As the battle escalates, growing fiercer by the second, the struggle comes to an end and the conqueror to be proclaimed. But both sides hold on to their courage. Who is the victor here? For one of them has been storing a trick up its sleeve. And it may strike a decisive blow when least expected. Why have I fallen? Despair. When happening upon a frozen statue, its terrifying creator soon reveals itself. The Lord of the Tundra is heartless and cold, showering its prey in an impenetrable veil of snow, leading foolish creatures to an icy grave.
Clouds torn apart, unleashing a torrent of rain. Then, an unrelenting typhoon connecting the heavens once again. Finally, it shows its form. A hurricane made of flesh. Bringing death through gale and storm. A dragon god ready to thresh.
Once again settled in his rightful place. To bring down the hammer of justice on the servants who betrayed him. With swift attacks, he smites the wicked. Hark, the cries of his traitors herald his return.